We are doing episode 38 and 39. We'll combine them here in this one, and then 40 will continue on. What we're looking at here is significant. It is getting all three major tribes of, or all three descendants of Abraham into this one goal, this target. This is a target. And you can see the Star of David here, and it's protected by the six-sided hexagram, which is what we know that's supposed to be in the center of David. It's supposed to be the protection, right? It's where the honeycomb, it's like the honeycomb where the bees are protected before their flight. The larvae is protected before flight. And it's, the Star of David again is the two symbols of the battle of good and evil, the two pyramids opposing each other that makes up this center, which is where God wants everyone to be. Right now the world is upside down. The wrong people are running it. And they're at the top. And God wants to take we the people and move us into position to show the world what his system is like. What is heaven like? We know what it's like. We had it here in America for a little while. We're going to bring that back for a short time to bring in the harvest. This particular crop circle, looking at it, I'll be getting deeper into it later on in the message. But to understand that this is all about dealing with judgment. What the world says against Christians, and what should be our response to it. And, dealing with the media, dealing with the world. The goal here is to bring Ishmael's people, the Arabs, bring in, the Jews, and bring in the Christians. All three groups are represented here to bring them into the kingdom of God. So, how are we going to do that in these last days? Well, God's got the answers. The answers are out here. The answers are in the Word. And we're going to look at some of the answers right now in these particular passages of Scripture, or these Psalms, Psalm 38, 39, and 40. And we'll see what God wants to do and how he wants to do it. We're trying to get everyone to come into the kingdom before the resurrection, so that way that we leave as minimal numbers behind as possible for judgment in the tribulation. Stay tuned.
This is WhiteHorse-Radio.com. The rider is here. The final battle is about to begin. You will need to pick a side.
It is the lion versus the blockheads.
You decide the team you want to side with. You decide the best action for you. Here's your host,
the head crusher for the Lions,
Brother Abel. He knows better than anyone a head injury can mess you up.
Psalm 38, a Psalm of David to bring to remembrance. O Lord, rebuke me not in thy wrath, neither chasten me in thy hot displeasure. For thine arrows stick fast in me, and thy hand presseth me sore. There is no soundness in my flesh because of thine anger, neither is there any rest in my bones because of my sin. For mine iniquities are gone over mine head, and as in a heavy burden they are too heavy for me. My wounds stink and are corrupt because of my foolishness. I am troubled, I am bowed down greatly, I go mourning all the day long. For my loins are filled with loathsome disease, and there is no soundness in my flesh. I am feeble and sore broken, I have roared by reason of the disquietness of my heart. Lord, all my desire is before thee, and my groaning is not hid from thee. My heart panteth, my strength faileth me, as for the light of mine eyes, it is also gone far from me. My lovers and my friends stand aloof from my sore, and my kinsmen stand afar off. They also that seek after my life lay snares for me, and they that seek me hurt, speak mischievous things, and imagine deceits all the day long. But I, as a deaf man, heard not, and I was a dumb man that opeth not his mouth. Thus I was a man that heareth not, and those whose mouth are no reproofs. For in thee, O Lord, do I hope. Thou wilt hear, O Lord my God. For I said, hear me, lest otherwise they should rejoice over me. When my foot slippeth, they magnify themselves against me. For I am ready to halt, and my sorrow is continually before me. For I will declare mine iniquity, I will be sorry for my sin. But mine enemies are lively, and they are strong, and they that hate me wrongfully are multiplied. They also that render evil for good are mine adversaries, because I follow the thing that good is. Forsake me not, O Lord, O my God, be not far from me. Make haste to help me, O Lord, my salvation. Amen. This is a Psalm of David. Psalm 38, We have witnesses in heaven. There are the 24 elders, 3/8, 8/8/8 equals 24. There's 20 and 4 elders around the throne room of God who lay their crowns before him. And these 24 elders, and there are judges, or judges. Jesus is the judge, and the final judge is of all. And when we look at the Psalm 38:12, it says, "They also that seek after my life lay snares for me, and that they seek my hurt speak mischievous things and imagine deceits all the day long. But as a deaf man heard not, I was a dumb man that opened not his mouth. Thus I was a man that heareth not, and whose mouth are no reproofs. For in thee, Lord, do I hope, that will hear, and Lord of my God. For I said, Hear me, lest otherwise they should rejoice over me with what my foot slippeth, and they magnify themselves against me. For I am ready to halt, and my sorrow is continually before me. For I will declare mine iniquity, I will be sorry for my sins. But mine enemies are lively, and they are strong, and they that hate me wrongfully are multiplied." The media today in government, where you're trying to run for office, I mean, they love to dig up the dirt, don't they? Don't they love to go into your background? Well, I don't got nothing to hide. I tell you, I'm a sinner, man. I have sinned, and, I've done things that are wrong. But the thing is that I have a Savior, a God who loves me. And he that is without sin, let him cast the first stone. You see, God, we see David here, he's crying out. You know, in today's society, multiplied. I mean, it would just be, you know, when one bad thing is heard amongst any candidate or anybody in public office, it's like multiplied a hundredfold in today's media. The media loves to bring out the trash. I mean, if there's anyone who's a great hand in the service of Satan, it is the media. The Bible says once it's under the blood, once you've given your sins under the blood, it's remembered no more. So all these people who interview out there with the microphones and stuff like that, just remember, people, on Judgment Day, your whole lives are going to be exposed. Those who have not come to Christ, those who have come to Christ and have put it under the blood, well, God remembers it no more. He sees that sin no more. It's invisible to him. He won't look beyond what his son did. He won't dig up the dirt. In other words, Jesus Christ is the greatest encryption program that the universe has ever known. He not only does he delete all the sin and all the objectionable material off your hard drive, but he reformats it, he restructures it, and he rewrites a new code into your life. That code is the Word of God. You get to know the Word of God and rewrite what's on your life. We are renewed by the transformation of our minds. We had stinking thinking before we came to Christ, and when we came to Christ, we gave our lives and our minds and our hearts over to God and his Word. Looking at this image, we see what God has done here in this image. It is a Star of David. But if you notice, the Star of David, the center point, the center of David, is this honeycomb. And we know that it's two triangles, two pyramids opposing each other. It's a force of good and evil. And the goal is to shape us. It's the forces are there to make us into better people. Like pressure on a piece of coal that makes a diamond. See, but God, right now the world is upside down. The wrong people are running this show, and God wants to take the people at the bottom and move them to the top. We the people of these United States, in order to form a perfect union, we the people need to rise up and take our position where God wants us to be and show the world what God's design is for the kingdom. We want to show the world God's kingdom. So we want to take the Star of David here is now protected around the honeycomb. The target is to get all the children of Israel and all of Ishmael's people, that's the Arabs, Muslims, and the Christians on target. The goal is to get everybody to see it the way God wants us to see it, to understand what this has all been about. And the goal is to bring everybody into the kingdom in this place of safety, which is the honeycomb. So as we pull one man from the bottom and move him to the top, the whole thing begins to spin around. The enemy begins to pursue the power. And the world begins to see what God is doing here. The world will begin to see the enemy pursuing the man with the power. What is this power? It is the Holy Spirit. It is the lamps of God. It is the power of God. It is the kingdom of God. It is leading people to the truth. It is taking darkness out of the earth and bringing light into it by shining the light and showing people what God's plans are for the last days. What is God's plans? To bring everybody to his Son. Hallelujah. That's the God whom I serve. The falling away is falling into the church. The goal, the target, to get everybody into the kingdom of God. When we look at this crop circle here, we first look at what's holy. We're looking at what's holy in this crop circle. The crop circle has on it, actually, 31 circles. Now, the double circles around the major circles, that just means we're all counting once on this. All right, and the center only needs to be counted once. Well, there are six arms times five circles in each arm. That's a total of 30. And then we get the center one, which is 31, getting all three tribes into one position. This is the target. This is a, you see, the circle is, the center is a target, the target. We're, this is the goal, this is the aim of what God wants to do in these last days, is to get us all on target, to get us all prepared for resurrection, to go home, all three tribes. That means Ishmael's group, that means the Israeli people, that means the Christians. And how do we do this? Well, the Christian church needs to unite under the one head church, which is Christ, Christ's head. That's what the rider of the white horse is. He's only a picture of Christ before Christ comes in. He is not Christ. I'll say it again. The rider of the white horse is not Christ. He's a picture of what's coming. He is, and the devil's afraid of him, and that's why he vilifies everything from the white horse on. You know, he vilifies this great king that stands up. He's vilifying everything. But the truth of the matter is it's going to leave him behind with little as possible. You understand that? So we have the 31, 3-1. With the Star of David, and then outside we have the honeycomb. Now there's 31 circles, the holy people, that's the Christians. And then with the Israel, and outside is the honeycomb, which is the safety, place of safety. Understand, Islam is rising up against a group of people who used the Son's name in vain and who stole America, who gone and corrupted the Word of God, who used the Word of God's name, who brought in idolatry, who brought in lies, who brought in deceptions into the church and insisted that they knew the truth. This has always been about two groups, Protestant and Catholic. America was a Protestant nation. And we were a great nation bringing out the word of God to people. But that wasn't good enough for one group of people. How can we say and dare say that we are one nation under God, and yet we weren't under the pontiff, you see? We were an independent nation. We were a free nation. Somebody hates freedom. They like slavery. They like ruling it over us and lording it over us. But if you want to know what heaven is like, you have to look at America in its heyday and how America was set up. We didn't lock our doors. Our kids were safe in the streets until whore and harlot came over here and put up her hives and her little covens. But we want to bring everybody to repentance and get them all in center on track. Even they can become to repentance and be saved before the resurrection. This is called mercy. This is called grace. So the 31 circles, we've got the 6 outside the hexagram. So 6 plus the 31 is 37. The Star of David is 38, and the two circles making up the targets, 39 and 40. So we're looking at Psalm 38, 39, and 40. Those are the Psalms we're going to be looking on. I'm going to continue on into Psalm 40 a little later on, but right now we're going to look at, we just looked at Psalm 37, we're going to look at Psalm 38, we're going to look at Psalm 39, and we're going to see how God deals with judgment. The media doesn't understand this. People in the world don't understand that God is forgiving mercifully. And he's willing to forgive all of them their sins if they will come to him. They can make first resurrection if they repent and give their lives to Christ. God loves each and every one of them. But to see the media, for some strange reason, has to drag up the dirt of what's in the past. Because what is it? Because of you. The Bible says that God is going to reward us in the same measure that he rewarded those at the beginning. Those who started at the beginning of the day, he made a wage, promised them a set course, a fee. Those who come at the middle of the day, they got the same promise. And those who came at the end of the day had the same promise. So we have the same promises that they had at the very beginning. They may have worked harder to get here. They may have worked a lot harder. You know, our saints may have gone and been martyred throughout history, but at the end of the age, just have to come to Christ. You don't have to go through martyrdom unless you're going to stay behind in the tribulation. Then you're going to get stuck behind in the martyrdom. But the ones that are going to be martyred are the ones who did the martyring. Do you understand that?